Eaton Cummins automated transmissions were designed for superior reliability, performance, and efficiency. This driver video will get you started as you head out on the road in your International LT truck.
Hi, I'm Zach.
Hi, I'm David.
Today we're going to talk to you about some common errors that are made when driving the Endurant transmission or other Eaton Cummins automated products. David, if I'm a new driver to automated transmissions or even to trucks in general, what are some common mistakes I may make or find myself doing in the Endurant transmission or other automated products?
So one of the biggest mistakes that drivers will make when they first get into an automated transmission is they like to put their foot to the metal right away. And the way that these things best react is easing onto the throttle and then going to about the 75% mark. What that's doing is it's giving the clutch time to engage and actually transition forward. If you think about a manual transmission, you're not just gonna put your pedal to the metal and dump the clutch. You have to give it time to start moving forward. Same thing is gonna be true here.
So really what you're saying is finesse is rewarded.
Correct. The lighter you are on it, the better it's gonna perform.
So David, what are some differences between a proper launch and an improper launch?
So first I'll demonstrate an improper launch. So you notice that we had very herky-jerky movement and it didn't feel smooth. Now I'll demonstrate what a proper launch should feel like. Ease onto the throttle and slowly start launching the vehicle. We're still getting skip shifts and the shifting is occurring at a much lower RPM. Could you feel the difference?
Yeah, absolutely. Much smoother that way. David, I've also heard of this concept called two-footing. What is that and is it to be used or not?
So two-footing is basically when you're touching the brake pedal and the throttle pedal at the same time. And the reason that that's bad is it sends confusing messages to the transmission. When you touch the brake pedal, we're telling the transmission that we need to open up the clutch to prevent a stall out. When you touch the throttle, we're telling it that it needs to engage the clutch so that we can start moving.
So really two-footing could be damaging to your transmission or other components on the truck.
Exactly. And with that urge to move functionality, you should find that you have a lot more control as you are trying to back into those situations. So you should find that two-footing is no longer needed. So one of the other common complaints that I get from drivers is the inability to go into gear after they have backed into a dock or they're at a fuel island and they've basically bled their air tanks down low. The way that the Endurant transmission operates is it's using air pressure to not only actuate the clutch, but also actuate the gears. So when you're low on air pressure, we need to see at least 90 PSI on the transmission before we allow it to go into gear. So if your air tanks are below 90 and you try and put it into gear, you'll likely hear an audible tone that says it can't go into gear and you'll be stuck in neutral until it gets the air pressure built. In order to fix this, what you really need to do is allow your air tanks to build up to at least 115, 120 PSI before you try and put it into gear.